What's up, chicas? Welcome back to my channel. Hopefully you guys are having a wonderful day. Today's video is going to be my top 5 drugstore foundation for oily, acne-prone skin. I have many of you guys, my subscribers, my friends on Snapchat. I have a lot of people that constantly ask me what is a good foundation for them. So I wanted to bring a video for you guys first. And then, of course, I'm going to bring a video for people who have my type of skin, which is dry to sensitive. So I also wanted to share with you guys because I use these foundations. So I won't be giving you here something that I don't know what I'm talking about. I'm going to be giving you my point of view because I've actually used these foundations and I'm pretty sure that they're excellent pick for oily to acne prone skin. The reason why also I love this foundation is because you guys know that I'm a matte girl. Matte eyeshadow, matte liner, matte lipstick, matte face, everything needs to be mattified for me to be comfortable. So I know that these foundations are going to work for you because I use them because I want matte. Even though my skin is dry sensitive, I still prefer a matte foundation over a dewy finish any day of my life. So if you guys want to know what are my top 5 picks for drugstore foundations for oily, acne prone skin, all you have to do is grab a snack. I'm gonna get you guys fat. And join me. Okay, so let's start off with the foundations. Is the Rimmel Stay Matte Foundation. This foundation is pretty amazing. It's a liquid mousse foundation. When it first came out, I was loving this foundation because it is so mattifying and the coverage is so good. I will dare to say that it's a full coverage foundation for me. If it was a full coverage foundation, if for you guys is medium or whatever, you can always build your coverage. I love this foundation because of the consistency. It is a liquid mousse foundation, so it starts off very liquidy, but you see, not very liquidy, but as soon as you apply it to your hand or wherever you apply it to before applying it to your face, it comes up easily, but the texture of it is like a mousse foundation. It's a lightweight and it's shine control. So even though it's like a mousse consistency and it's a matte, it's still lightweight, so it's not gonna clog your pores and you're not gonna feel cakey and you're not going to feel like you have tons of makeup on. Even though it's mattifying and it's like a mousse consistency, it's very lightweight and I love the coverage that it gives me. I do have scar. I don't have acne scar, but I do have a scar on my face where I had a car accident when I was 9 years old and they put some of the things that they saw them in or whatever. Right now my mind went blank. I can't tell what they're called, but my skin opened up and they had to close it. And I had like 12 of those clips in my face for like a whole entire week. So I have a pretty big scar on my face. So I look for a foundation that is gonna help me cover that scar. Not only that, I have a lot of redness all over my face and I have a lot of different colors on my skin, on my face. All my face is not even color, so I have like dark patches or red patches all over my face. So I have to find a foundation that is gonna cover that as well. So that's why I say that I can talk for people who have acne scars or whatever, because I also have things in my face that I would like to cover, like that scar. So I saw that this foundation did cover my scar very well. So I really love it. The fact that it's lightweight and it felt like it was not clogging my pores, I was like, good. Because I don't want to bring so much mattifying or drying to my face. My face is already dry enough. So, but this was pretty good. And the only downside to this foundation is that you only get about 8 shades. Yes, I know. I really like a foundation that's going to have like a wide range of colors, because like that more people have the option of choosing a foundation. But this is the only downside to it, that it only has 8 shades. So the other one is the Revlon Color Stay 24 Hour Foundation. This one is really good. I only used it a couple of times and I have to tell you guys, I did love it. I don't know why I didn't go back to it. I really was like, why did I go back to this foundation? This foundation lasts for a very long time. That's what you need. You need a foundation that's gonna last you for your whole entire day, that is not gonna have the shine breakthrough and your T-zone is gonna get all oily and you have to be coming back and applying powder because you are like a grease ball. I understand that. I don't have the problem, but I do understand because I have very close family members or very close friends who have this problem, and I have been able to help them with, hey, listen, this foundation works wonders for your skin. So this foundation, love the fact that it's like a water-based foundation. So with this foundation, with the Rimmel, I recommend you applying it with a top flat kabuki brush so that actually works into your skin. This foundation, because it's a water-based foundation, I recommend you using a beauty blender or a makeup sponge. You can buy the beauty blender at Sephora, or you can just get the Real Techniques sponge for $5, which is the one I'm currently using, and I absolutely love it. It does the same thing. So this foundation, I love the fact that it has, I think it has like 20 shades, so you can definitely find a shade for you. If not, you can also customize the shade. Also, the foundation is a full coverage foundation. I saw that it hide my dark spots. I saw that it hide my scar, and I saw that it gave me a flawless matte finish, and it lasts me a very, very long time. The next one is my holy grail. I love this foundation, and it's the Maybelline Fit Me Foundation Matte and Poreless. This foundation, I have to say, for me, it's like a medium to full coverage. It's definitely buildable. Love, it's not a, for me, it wasn't like a really mattifying finish. It was more like a demi matte finish, I would say. So this matte and poreless foundation, it says it's for normal to oily skin. It's super, super, super easy to blend. It's more like a watery consistency. It's not as thick as the Rimmel. Of course, the Rimmel is the mousse. It's not as watery as the Revlon Colorstay, but it's in between, so it has a pretty scent, a very good coverage to it, and it definitely stays matte for a very long time. It doesn't say that it's gonna last you 8 hours, 12 hours, or whatever, but my holy grail foundation from the drugstore has to be this one right here, and it's really, really good, ladies. I highly recommend the matte Maybelline Fit Me foundation because it's amazing balls. I love that foundation from the drugstore, and it's cheap. It ranges around $5.99, if I'm not mistaken, at Walmart. And this is the CoverGirl Outlast 3-in-1 foundation. This one I recommend for people who would like to be on the run. Like, listen, Francis, I don't have time to prime my face, to conceal my face, to moisturize my face. I just want a foundation that's gonna do everything. It's gonna hide my pores. I'm sorry, it's gonna hide my acne scars. And it's definitely gonna give me a coverage that I can trust. And definitely is not gonna have my T-zone oily during the day. Right here. This has amazing full coverage. I love the fact that it's full coverage. It's not as mattifying as any of the three ones I showed you. It definitely leaves your skin like a matte dewy finish, I would say. I don't know if you get what I'm saying, but it's really, really good. It has your primer, it has your concealer, so it's the type of thing that you can wear. I recommend wearing it with a beauty blender so it blends beautifully to your skin, and it definitely is gonna last all day. If you want to have like an event full coverage all day type of thing, I recommend the CoverGirl 3-in-1 foundation. And the last one is because I've had a love and hate relationship with it, but I managed to break through that, and I've managed to be able to find the reason why I didn't like it, and I managed it. I say, huh, I'm gonna make you my bitch. I'm just kidding. So it's the L'Oreal Infallible Pro Matte Foundation. This is raved in here in YouTube, like there's no tomorrow. Like, this foundation is like, oh my god, oh my god, oh my god. And yes, it's oh my god. The only thing I didn't like about this foundation is very hard to match your skin color. This foundation, it's a 24-hour foundation. It lasts for a while. Here in the back, it tells you that the finish is a demi matte finish. So even though it says it's a pro matte foundation, it's not gonna give you like a full matte on effect on your face right away. It's a demi matte foundation, so it's kind of good because it makes you feel like you don't have a lot of makeup, so it doesn't make you feel all cakey. And then it says that the coverage is medium. It lasts 24 hours, and the texture is a light. So the coverage is medium. You can always build the coverage. It's not a full coverage foundation, and it's not like an all full matte foundation. A trick that I can tell you is if you mix these two foundations, you're gonna get a great amount of coverage, and it's gonna look so, so good your skin, because you're doing like a matte finish foundation and like a demi matte foundation, and then you're doing like a very very lightweight foundation and a 24-hour foundation. So these two right here, I did try them together and I loved the combination. Any mattifying foundation, of course you guys know it's gonna do the trick for you guys. It's gonna help you avoid going in the day and having to retouch your makeup because you're oily. Some people do because they're extremely oily, then that is not going to work. Then that is not going to work with foundation, like with the foundation covering it, and that's it. That is going to have to be due to your skincare routine to be able to control your oils of your face, and then you can jump into a foundation that you're not gonna have that problem. But I love these foundations. I recommend for any type. If you still have dry skin and you still want to look mattified, try them. I use them. They don't break me out at all. They give me flawless coverage, beautiful coverage, and I definitely recommend all these foundations because they're amazing. I hope you found this video helpful. If you have any other concern, any other questions you guys have, like anything you want me to do a research on and do it in a video instead of you guys going online and reading it, I'll make a video for you guys. Just let me know. So if you like this type of videos, don't forget to give this a video a thumbs up. And if you have any friends who have acne prone skin and have oily skin and are looking for a better foundation or better foundation routine, share this video with them. And go ahead and hit that subscribe button so you can be a part of my Amazeballs family here on YouTube. Thank you so much for your love. Thank you so much for your continued support. Mwah! Besos to you guys, and I will see you guys on my next video. Bye.